Well, our top story tonight, Uttar Pradesh's Chief Minister Adityanath has been unapologetic about the high-handed way in which he and his administration have dealt with the Anti-Citizenship Act protesters in the state. There have been ghastly images of peaceful protesters being dragged and beaten by the police for weeks now. And now the Chief Minister himself seems to be intimidating women protesters in particular, who have been in the forefront of many peaceful demonstrations. My colleague Alok Pandey has the story.
Yogi Adityanath leading the BJP's CAA charge with almost daily rallies across Uttar Pradesh and elsewhere in India in the last week. So far, the Chief Minister has addressed 7 rallies in UP cities, including in Varanasi and Gorakhpur. He also addressed a rally in Bihar's Gaya town, where a major anti-CAA protest is on. But in the last 2 days, the UP Chief Minister's repeated attacks against women protesting the citizenship law have run into controversy. On Wednesday, the Chief Minister made this remark.
अब इन्होंने क्या किया है? अपने घर की महिलाओं को चौराहे चौराहे पर बिठाना प्रारंभ कर दिया है। बच्चों को बिठाना प्रारंभ कर दिया है। कितना बड़ा अपराध कि पुरुष घर में सो रहा है रजाई ओढ़ करके और महिलाओं को आगे करके चौराहे चौराहे पर बिठाया जा रहा है।
Mr. Adityanath repeated his women being pushed to the front remarks this afternoon at a rally in Agra with BJP President JP Nadda.
जो लोग कल तक सीमी के आह्वान पर, PFI के आह्वान पर, जगह-जगह आगजनी की घटनाओं को अंजाम दे रहे थे, आज उनको लगने लग गया कि अब अवैध रूप से बनाई गई प्रॉपर्टी जब्त हो गई, अब अपनी महिलाओं को और बच्चों को आगे करके जगह-जगह माहौल खराब करने का प्रयास कर रहे हैं।
Behind me is Lucknow's iconic clock tower और घंटाघर, where all of these women have been sitting in continuous protest since last Friday. We spoke to many of them here. All of them say they will not be intimidated by what the government is doing or saying, and that their protests will continue.
At the clock tower, college student Fauzia, a volunteer who has been present at the protest all 7 days, says she has an answer for the Chief Minister's allegations.
Everybody who is just sitting here, they all know about CAA. That's why we are here on roads. People who have migrated to India before 31st December 2014, they will be given citizenship, except Muslims and Jews.
जो आज की महिला है, वो बहुत मजबूत है, बहुत हिम्मत और हौसला रखती है, और जिस तरीके की भाषा का इस्तेमाल हमारे माननीय मुख्यमंत्री जी कर रहे हैं, शायद आज तक के रिकॉर्ड में किसी मुख्यमंत्री की ये भाषा नहीं रही होगी।
So far, the UP police have filed 3 criminal cases against the Lucknow women, accusing them of rioting, among other serious charges. But none of the women have been arrested so far. In Lucknow, with Rajesh Gupta and Kamal Khan, this is Alok Pandey, NDTV.
And joining us now on the program is senior journalist Swati Chaturvedi. Mr. Deshratan Nigam, a supporter of the RSS, also with us this evening. Mr. Nigam, why is the UP Chief Minister so angry with women protesters who are not doing anything except expressing their right to dissent in a peaceful way?
See, what probably you're referring to Itawa. The Itawa, if you look at the entire record, and police has also gone on record and it has put it in the FIR and before the court, that the entire traffic was blocked and an ambulance was also, which was carrying a critical patient, was also blocked. And the senior most officers tried to convince the women to at least to remove the blockade. But during that time, when they were trying to talk to the people, somebody pelted stones. And therefore, as per protocol, a mild force was used, and this is on record. And it was also in violation of Section 144, which is the law if it is imposed. And if you more than 4 people are there, then it becomes a duty of the people to disperse the crowd. And I think the maximum restraint was used by the people. You have not shown the entire episode. And the stones were actually, some stones were pelted, and then the police said no.
I don't see much restraint being used by the police in the pictures that we have on air, but can you explain to us what he means when he says these women do not even know what they are protesting against? They are being made to sit in dharnas while the men are sleeping in quilts at their homes. What does he mean by that, Mr. Nigam? The women don't have a mind of their own?
See, let me point out during Jamia, there was a special strategy was adopted, and we have the screenshots of the WhatsApp messages ki ladkiyon ko aage karo, put the girls in front. And the boys had decided exactly the same strategy is being applied, that put the women and children in front. When the children, videos on social media,
women are
when
not,
the children are saying kill Prime Minister Modi.
Do you know how
Modi
completely patronizing, condescending, and sexist that sounds? How patronizing that sounds,
that women don't have a mind of their own. No, let me tell you.
We don't have our own will to protest.
That's your conclusion. That's your conclusion.
It's not your conclusion.
Let me finish, please. I am not in the studio. Let me finish.
Neither is Swati.
No. Let me finish and then she can come.
I'm alone here today, mercifully. Swati, just on this point, sir. Let me finish.
One second, Mr. Nigam, on this particular point, Swati is coming in.
Nidhi, I want to say first of all that Mr. Desh Ratan Nigam represents an organization which is steeped in patriarchy. There are no women allowed in the RSS. But Yogi Adityanath has a medieval mindset. He's gone one further step further than the RSS also. I've written about this. There are so many problematic things he said about women. You know, in his own writings, where he said that women should not work outside the house, the woman's energy, urja, is harmful, it has to be harnessed by a man. You know, these are medieval, patriarchal mindsets. And when you see them, and the kind of comments that Yogi Adityanath has made about women, I mean, I personally feel extremely insulted.
Yeah, Mr. Nigam? I mean, are you saying women don't have their own agency?
Let me come in. I don't think anybody is saying that, but when you employ as a strategy to put women in front and then shield yourself behind the women, that is the objection. Obviously, women have their own independent mind.
Strategy?
And similarly, RSS also has a Rashtri Sevika Samiti, which is already there, and we have lakhs of women volunteers and members
out there.
But why
aren't women in the RSS?
So I think ignorance of facts cannot be condoned.
Why are they segregated?
No, we have like any party, any organization, they have a women wing. You have a Mahila Congress also. You have a BJP also as a Mahila wing also. So therefore, why is the RSS so strict on male purity? Let us be very, very clear also. No, there is no male purity. I think that's your interpretation. That's your interpretation that you are trying to enforce on us. Let us not go. Read our literature.
Mr. Nigam, what are the pracharaks?
Pracharaks don't marry. Pracharaks don't marry because it's a very tedious job. They have to travel all India, they have to work in circumstances.
The bigger point
therefore, they cannot fulfill the pattern in which the Adityanath government
is dealing with protesters, right? Now, we've seen this for several weeks now, Swati. There is a certain clear high-handedness in the approach. If it had happened in any other state, they would say there's a breakdown of law and order. What is the bigger political messaging that you take away from what's happening in UP for the past month?
Well, Nidhi, not just what's happening in the past month, but from all of Yogi's tenure, ever since Yogi's taken over, you've seen this, you know, crackdown. First, we had those Romeo squads, which are pulling out people for what they claim were illegal activities. Now, 25 people have died. Now, Yogi, to say this kind of thing that women have no agency, which he really believes, because it's a very patriarchal mindset, and, you know, to demean the protesters like this, I think it's something that, Bharati Janata Party talks about beti bachao, beti padhao, and this is their patriarchal mindset.
Mr. Nigam, are you willing to acknowledge that not
let
every protester
yes,
out there is motivated by politics or some other, that there actually are people who are genuinely upset about the Citizenship Act and the possibility of an NRC? Would you acknowledge that there are genuine protests too, or are they all motivated? Everyone is being put as a front to some other sinister conspiracy.
See, let me tell you, the genuineness of the protest of some protesters cannot be doubted. Let me put it on record. But they are under misconception of the fact that their citizenship would be taken away. So that is where the genuineness is compromised. Let me also bring out certain facts that UP police recovered 500 cartridges of prohibited bore, which is not used by police during firing. And 300 policemen were injured, 65 of them were injured through firearms. Only one person died of police bullet in Bijnor. That is the post-mortem reports which are saying. So let us not paint it. Let us go by facts and hard evidence on record. Yes, 144 is there. Everyone has to obey the law. And if NDTV is saying that you should violate 144, then I'm sorry. And yes, well, you have a right to protest, peaceful protest.
144 has very clearly been misused.
Block the road.
Itawa, and if you recall what the Supreme Court has said about 144 in the context just last week while listening to the Kashmir hearing.
I am aware of 144.
Come on, Mr. Nigam. It has been misused and in Uttar Pradesh.
You can't block an ambulance.
Not all these women blocked an ambulance. They deserve to be beaten if they were peacefully protesting. I am a panelist. You are an anchor. Allow me to speak. You've been speaking, Mr. Nigam. You've been Swati. Would like to come in now. Swati.
No, you're not allowing me to complete my sentence.
Mr. Nigam, please, could you let Swati complete my sentence? Because this is not meant to be a monologue, very respectfully.
Swati, you took away half my time. I'm bringing down the mic. Swati Chaturvedi, it's your turn.
Yes, thank you, Nidhi. Mr. Nigam, we just wait for a bit. Let me speak. Now, you know, 25 people have died in these protests only in UP. All right, now that is something Yogi Adityanath has got a novel thing which is totally anti-constitutional, where he's going around seizing people's property. And then now to come out and insult all the women protesters by saying that they are pawns in the hands of their men who are under a razai while these women are sitting on the chauraha. This is, by the way, not very good language either. So, you know, I don't quite understand why a chief minister of a state would be insulting the women of his own state and also the men. By saying this kind of thing that jo aadmi razai mein baitha hua hai aur tenko chaurahe pe bitha diya hai, what does he mean? These women are all born?
Yeah. Mr. Nigam?
Yeah, let me answer. I have already answered about that razai and things. I think that's the interpretation Swati is deliberately trying to impose on all of us. Now, let me also point out
that's
recovery
said,
notices
it's to not people an interpretation.
Who
it's
are
a,
violent
it's
rioters who damage.
He said it.
Don't button. Let me answer. So far as the recovery of damages is concerned, it is on direction of the Supreme Court. The Allahabad High Court framed guidelines, and all the recovery is on the basis of those guidelines of the Allahabad High Court. It is not unconstitutional. Let Swati Chaturvedi correct its facts. It is as per the guidelines of Allahabad High Court. 25 PFI people who have been arrested here, who were radical Islamists, and the UP government has asked the Home Ministry to ban PFI in UP. And therefore, let us be very clear.
Mr. Nigam, you
have to see the facts, how it has happened.
Swati, yes, last
Mr. Nigam, can I ask you a question? I want to ask a question.
By shaving their head and beard. Yes.
Swati.
Mr. Nigam, why did the UP Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath say ki hum inse badla lenge? And then the property seizures started. Now, which language of the Constitution is this to talk about revenge?
No, certainly.
Exactly where it started, I'm afraid we're completely out of time, but there's been a very clear pattern
as far as dealing with the protests in UP have been concerned. You can see that, and those concerns actually, Mr. Nigam, were also raised by the Allahabad High Court earlier this month, that has actually demanded a response from the UP government on what it sees as the deteriorating law and order situation and internet shutdowns in the state. So this is something that the Allahabad High Court too has taken note of, as far as the way the state has dealt with law and order post AMU and these protests. Thanks very much to both of you for joining us.